So you're thinking about moving to Boise, Idaho, but don't know much about the area. Well, you're in luck. I'm Isaac Crace, a fourth generation Idahoan. I was born and raised here in the Valley, so I know it like the back of my hand. And today I'm gonna take you on a tour of the entire Boise area. We're gonna start on the Boise Bench, go downtown Boise, check out downtown Boise a little bit up through the north end. Then we're gonna go to Hidden Springs and Avamore just to give you a feel on what area might be best for you. We're gonna go over prices, what's available for housing, and what activities there are. So sit back and enjoy the ride.
Okay, so we are heading to the Boise Train Depot. It was actually built in 1925. It's a Spanish style building and it is actually not a functioning train station. Nowadays they are using them for venues, weddings, whatnot. The depot is located in the Boise Bench area. Mm-hmm. The Boise Bench, named for its location, the sunrise in elevation from downtown Boise gives that prominent appearance of step or bench, and is raised in elevation approximately 60 feet overlooking the city. Great shopping, great restaurants, and a couple of nice parks where kids and families like to go out. And check out this view. Isn't this beautiful?
Yeah, this is gonna be like the classic view whenever you see people taking pictures, business pictures or whatnot, from the train depot looking down Capitol Boulevard with the Idaho State Capitol in the background. Around here you're going to find condo living with smaller, simple size, two bedroom, one bath condos starting at the $300,000 price range. Or you can also find your 30 to 40 year old townhome starting in the mid 300s. Three bedroom, one to two bath on a smaller lot. And you're going to find your older three bed, two bath, 1,500 to 2,000 square foot mid-century homes on 0.16 acre lots. The nicely upgraded and updated ones are gonna start in the high 400 range. If you go through the Boise State campus, you gotta check out the impressive brick buildings and the Albertson Stadium with the famous blue turf or Smurf turf. Bicycling, scootering, jogging, walking, just going for a stroll in the afternoon. If that's the kind of thing that you like to do, then the Boise Greenbelt is gonna be your cup of tea. It runs right through Boise, down past Eagle. It starts all the way up by Lucky Peak and goes past Eagle. It's 20 miles long, the main stretch, but there's a lot of other offshoots that make it about 30 miles. I don't even think you could walk it in the whole day, even if you wanted to. So if this is something that sounds like your cup of tea, then you definitely want to check out the Boise Greenbelt. Along the Boise River, you're also going to find the expansive Julie Davis Park, home to the Zoo Boise, the Boise Art Museum, and Idaho State Museum. So since I'm over here by Julia Davis Park on the Greenbelt, I want to take you guys and show you something really cool. It's a memorial that was put up a few years ago, and it's the Anne Frank Human Rights Memorial. Downtown Boise is the city's cultural center and home to numerous shops, an abundance of restaurants, microbreweries, and nightlife venues. Downtown Boise is energetic, clean, and it's a livable community, and it's super walkable and friendly. Make sure you visit 8th Street. It's a pedestrian-only street between Main Street and Bannock, with a ton of great restaurants offering indoor and outdoor dining. Don't forget, make sure to stop by and check out Freak Alley. So downtown Boise is gonna be more of an entertainment, shopping, and office area. So the number of homes in the area is really gonna be exceptionally low. While you're in Idaho, we have our own local candy company. It's called Owyhee Candy Company. They make the famous Idaho Spud Bar. It's marshmallow covered in chocolate and coconut. So I'm gonna have mine, but be sure to pick one up while you are in town. As you head north of downtown Boise, you're gonna find the affluent North End, and it is probably the nicest or one of the most sought after areas of the entire valley or in Boise, just because people are attracted to that kind of foothills area and the older homes because they're built in the early to mid 1900s. Lots of people like to go in and flip those homes or just keep them as they are because they like that style. An interesting fact, since the North End is so expensive now, it used to be a blue-collar area, and it was where people who didn't have much money worked. So the times have definitely changed that, so it is one of the most sought-after areas in the entire valley.
You're gonna find a variety of different type of homes in the North End. The home prices in the area start at around $600,000. You can find the turn-of-century bungalow-style homes. Most of them are nicely updated and upgraded. You can also find some really stylish mid-century modern in the area. And of course, the famous Harrison Boulevard, where home prices range from the mid 700,000 to well over a million. One just got sold not long ago for what, 2 million?
As we roll through the north end, we're going to come up to Hyde Park, and it's not actually a park. It's a street that has buildings on each side of it, and they have shops. They have a Goodies, which is a little candy shop. They have different coffee shops along the ways, some gift shops, some eateries, that kind of stuff, and they have festivals there all the time, parades, and it's right next to Camelsback Park. Fun thing about Camelsback Park is it is a big park and it goes into the foothills. So that is kind of the entrance, like into the foothills, where you can take your mountain bikes, you can go hiking, you can walk your dogs, you can go run. And if you're feeling up to it, try and run up that hill at Camelsback Park. I'm gonna tell you right now, it is not fun. So driving past the park, if you look over to the right hand side, you're gonna notice that there's some stuff up against the bottoms of the trees. Well, in the winter, the city puts hay bales up against the trees because people like to go sledding there when we get snow. So it's a lot nicer to hit a hay bale instead of a tree stump. So that is the reasoning behind that. Now we're gonna be turning onto Harrison Boulevard, and it is probably the most notable street in just about all of Idaho, I'd have to say. It's actually Boise's first planned community, and when they first came in the 1900s, there was a stipulation where the builders had to build a home that cost at least $2,500, between $2,500 and $5,000. And they planted tons of trees, about 3,000 elm and maple trees along each side of the street and in the median. And now they're all grown up, so it's absolutely gorgeous. For those of you who have kids, if your kids want to catch the mother load of candy bars when they go trick-or-treating, take them to Harrison Boulevard. Harrison Boulevard actually turns into Bogus Basin Road as you go up the foothills. And I'll give you a hint where they came up with the name Bogus Basin Road. Yeah, you probably didn't have to think that hard about it. It's because it goes up to the Bogus Basin Ski Resort. It's the closest ski resort to Boise. They even have, in the summertime, they have an alpine slide or an alpine rail. And you can take your mountain bikes up there and mountain bike during the summertime, ski during the winter. So it really runs all year round and it's gorgeous. Heading out of Boise, the next town we're gonna go to and take you guys is Hidden Springs. The thing that is super cool about this is it's a small community kind of nestled in a little valley just north of Boise. It was built in the early 2000s. The cool thing about Hidden Springs is it's not like your cookie cutter neighborhood. It is custom built homes. There's less than 1,000 of them. And when they built it, the owners, when they sold the land to the developers, they wanted to keep the older style. So even though the homes were built in the early 2000s, they have the older feel with the wraparound porches, the kind of farmhouse style. No two houses are alike. So you have the older style homes with the granite countertops, the pergo flooring, the LVT flooring, the huge doorways, the expansive houses, and huge garages. Now, around Hidden Springs, since it's tucked away from Boise in its own valley, it has access to 800 acres of parks, trails, you name it, you can do it. So if you like to go hiking, biking in the foothills, or just be out of the hustle bustle, but still within 10 to 15 minutes of it, Hidden Springs might be just the thing you're looking for. Leaving Hidden Springs towards Highway 55, we're gonna snake around to Avamore, which is the next development on this list. It's not its own city, it's a neighborhood, but it does have its own post office and a gas station and a gym. It's its really own self-sufficient community area. It's got a community square that's 12,000 square feet, community center, swimming pool, a fitness center, 7 parks, and a vibrant Main Street. So far, Avamore is in an 840-acre planned community area, but they have 22,000 more acres set aside for future development. So there's the great opportunity there for Avamore to grow. Home prices in here are gonna be starting around the $600,000 to $700,000 mark and go up to $1.5 million. I hope you found this video helpful, and I have all the information that I used down below in the description. Be sure to stick around to next week's video where we're gonna go check out Eagle and Star. See ya.